am the project manager for the design team with Evans, and I've led that group over the last 4 months in producing this design document. As we said at the end of phases of design, one of the main components of this phase was to go back and do the research and test to justify the design that was proposed in phases of design. Now, walk you through. So, the slide shows the tests that we completed in schematic design. I'll walk you through it. Canopy metals report done by Deep Nortis Veritas, metallurgist who reviewed the assembly of the metals that we proposed for the canopy. Canopy performance report by Weiss, Jamie Elsinore, or WJE, as we call it. Geotechnical report by Caracon, they're a local subcontractor, sub-consultant. They've actually produced a lot of the geotechnical reports in St. Pete. Code report, Borough Happel worked hand-in-hand with St. Pete Building Department to identify the code, applicable codes, and develop strategies to meet them. Sea level rise report, again by Borough Happel, to assure that we were out of the FEMA requirements or within the FEMA requirements and out of the wave force level. Land survey, George F. Young, again a local sub-consultant. Underwater sonar survey, George F. Young, again. What they did is a 3D survey of the existing pier and where the existing piles are. Which will be very helpful for us during design, but also extremely helpful during demolition and construction. Wind wave report by Nuclear Engineering. Again, this is a study of the forces created by the wind and the waves on the pier. Structural wind study, cladding wind study by RWDI, a national firm. Their study, confirmed the structural assembly for the canopy and actually resulted in reducing the weight of the steel on the overall canopy. Caisson inspections done on the Clear and Engineering actually did the inspections in the water. This report actually confirmed the assumptions of the conditions of the caissons. If you read through the report, you'll notice that they didn't find anything that they didn't expect. It has confirmed that we can continue to use the caissons for low capacity that we're looking to apply to them. We will be doing some further inspections of those caissons as demolition commences. Life safety report, we're all happy working with the St. Pete Fire Department. In the report, you'll see snippets or screenshots of the animation that they did. The animation is amazing to get a chance to go down to the fire department and see it. The fire department seems to be satisfied with that report. At this point, we'll continue to work with them. Structural schematic report by Burl Happel, a marine structural report by ATM, as mentioned, underwater future grant application by GDP Environmental, which is we're waiting for a response on that or what the outcome of that is. So I'm going to walk you through the highlights of the developments and enhancements of the project as it's responded to the reports and analysis that we've done over the last 4 months. Briefly, is this one? Yeah. All right, so we optimized the turnaround at the hub. We increased the hub area. We've widened the over water drive. We've widened the over water bridge. We enhanced the bike path transition as it intersects with the over water bridge. Optimized canopy, we enlarged the promontory. Validated and enlarged the balconies. And we've enlarged and relocated the cafe. And lastly, we've optimized the marina. And I'll briefly walk you through each one of these. If I can. Starting at the top right, first we've increased the plaza area, which would be the white area, not the asphalted area, by 5,000 square feet. Maintained 120-foot diameter for ladder truck turnaround, and we've incorporated a valet parking area in front of what would eventually be the restaurant area. We've increased the accommodations for a 75-foot square foot future restaurant, and in doing so, we've also increased the hub by about 1,900 square feet. Overwater drive is now been increased to 22-foot clear. We have a 5-foot wood deck flush with the surface now on the south side. The pier itself, again, as I said, in the raising sea level, we've raised it. I think it's about 24 inches, both to keep it out of the wave forces, also to keep it above the rising, anticipated rising tide. We've switched to Florida I-beams, and based on the design, we were assuming double T's, and now we've gone to Florida I-beams. In doing so, we've also eliminated a topping slab, which was very costly, and now we're going with a finished structural slab. Overwater bridge, Florida I-beams, finished structural slab, and we've increased the width by 12-foot clear. We've also eliminated the metal soffit on the overwater bridge, which in doing the wind study, seeing some forces on the soffit, so by eliminating them, we were able to save money and eliminate that concern. Marina, this is a plan that if we got comments, it's hard to read. So let me try to walk you through it a little bit. If you can see that dot, that's actually an overpass. So that's the water bridge, and the boats would go underneath that. What we've done is, in the base of the design, the marina was an oval shape, and now it's a circle, pure circle. This helped us kind of standardize the sections. It also allows, by standardizing, it also allowed us to widen those sections. Now we're at 13 feet on the east side and 15 feet on the west side. So it's increased the fishing, area. We've maintained the overall area of the interior, and it still can accommodate 24 boats. And on the upper right-hand side, we've enhanced this is the bike path, and this is the overwater bridge, and we have a bollard here. So basically, we've improved the transition between the bike and the overwater bridge. This was a concern that we heard multiple times early on in that design. Oh, and one last thing, sorry. The area that says elevated marina overlook, we widened that by 2 feet. Promontory, again, starting in the upper right-hand corner, we increased the size of the promontory by 4,800 square feet. The turnaround is 11 feet, 70-foot diameter turnaround. Identified a new fishing area. The 5-foot wood boardwalk again on the south side of the pier now with the vehicle access. In this case, it's down the middle, coming down the overwater drive. It's actually on the north side now. In doing this, what we've done is we've relocated, one of the big moves is we relocated the cafe and we elevated it about 2.5 feet. By doing that, it gives you great views into the underwater reef area as well as the south of the pier. We've also increased the size of the seating area, the learning steps. It can now accommodate 285 individuals. And we've also added an ADA or handicap ramp for accessibility. The canopy. Four things that have when we consider optimizing the canopy. First is the bike path slot. The bike path used to go underneath the canopy, and now what we've done is we've allow the bike path to cut through the canopy. The bay window has increased in size, and we've increased the height of the balconies and the observation deck. And we've also increased the opening where the bike path would penetrate the canopy initially. In doing all of this, has increased the overall size of the canopy by 5%, about 3,000 square feet. And we've increased the height to 104 feet. This is, hopefully everyone can see this, what we're representing here. This is a section through the balcony area. And the two things I think are important to point out is, again, we've raised the height of the top balcony to 67 feet, 3 inches. But we've also connected it with a series of stairs that gets you directly down to the bike path, establishing a second means of egress off the balcony spaces. And lastly, the lighting design. The lighting design is more fully detailed and described in your package. But I wanted to show this image. It's an early conceptual image from the lighting designer of La Observatoire out of New York. And the reason why I wanted to show this is that early on in the basis of design, we spoke about underwater lights. And here we're showing more, they really animate the underwater reef area as well as the marina area. But the thing I wanted to point out is that the light fixture that's being specified here is a local manufacturer out of San Diego. They've developed and tested that fixture here in the same key. We're really happy to have that fixture. We'll think it'll look great in this project. And then lastly, our technical review. And I wanted to kind of touch base on these two consultants. Deck Nordis Veritas, an international expert, metallurgists. They deal with oil rigs, ships, detailing, mostly corrosion. We brought them on to do a peer review of our assembly in terms of materials. Their report is in our document. It's a good report, and it's worth really paying attention to it. They've made some recommendations that we followed in terms of the actual alloy of the aluminum and the canopy. But the second one, Weiss, Janie, Elsinore, they'll remain on our team to continue to do peer review of our assembly as the team finishes the design for the canopy. They're a national expert, they're very well known, and they're very good. And again, their report is actually quite detailed. They make some very good recommendations in the report, some that we will continue to explore and believe in the basis of design, or I'm sorry, into design development. Again, they will stay on the team and serve as our peer review going forward. At this point, I'll hand it back to Raul.